Welcome back to social session of grade 8. In the previous classes, we are speaking about Jainism. And today class, we are going to speak about the one more person, that is none other than Buddha, or the Buddhism, we can call it, or the Buddha's preachers were they, that is, we are calling as a Buddhism. Who is this Buddha? Gautama Buddha, we are calling also. So his name was, actually his name was Siddhartha. Who has become later came to known as the Gautama Buddha. Actually, he was born in the year 6th century BCE. His father was Suddhodana, the king of Republic of Shakya. Renouncing king, luxurious family life, luxury and family happiness, luxury and happiness he was. Siddhartha became a emirate. He left all the things, he privileged the ways, he embarked upon the quest of truth, he attained the enlightenment also, he became Buddha. After becoming Buddha, the enlightened one, the Buddha means we are calling here the enlightened one, he is the first went to Saranatha near, we can call as the, it is near to the, first he went to the Saranath, that is near Banaras, there in the deer park, he gave his first sermon. This is been called Dharma Chakra Pravartana. Here he preached the four noble truths and eightfold path also. The four noble truths are declared, whole world is full of sorrow and suffering. They also explain the root cause for sorrow. Buddha realized that desire is the root cause of sorrow. Only by the liberalization of excessive desires could peaceful life be led. Buddha preached the eightfold path, eliminating desire. This is called middle path. Apart from the what are the Buddha is saying, that is the desire. Aseye dukkake moolanta heltane. Other than that, he said that eightfold path that will be we have recorded as like this. One is action, speech, vision, livelihood, efforts, recollection, resolve, and thought. The Buddha's eightfold paths we are seeing as one is action, second one is speech, third one is vision, livelihood, effort, recollection, resolve, and thought. What is the next followers of the new religion? Wealthy merchant, artisans and common people were inspired by the new teaching. Buddha gave his message in the language which is called as a Prakrit, the language of the Andustan. This is a common language of the people, related to them in the various aspect of their tradition also. Atmosphere of the new cities changed the ways life of the people. The new religion become a ray of hope and change the circumstances also. Buddhism especially took on a new role of transferring the lives of people also. Buddha and his followers visited Kosala, Magadha and many cities of the Gangetic Plain, spread his messages there. He walked from the city another and devoted their lives for the others. In his 80 years, Buddha glorious life of the selfish service came to an end, Kushinaga. This has been called Mahaparinirvana. We are calling the name of the Mahaparinirvana. Viharas were constructed in the areas in the Buddha wandered. People preserved his relics and bones in the Chaitalyas and Stupas. And in memory of the accomplishment of started worshipping him, this was how the first temple idol worship began. Buddhism spread not only in India but also foreign countries. Chinese traveler like Fa Yan, It Singh and Huan Sang have described widely and glory of Buddhism. Buddhism had spread Malaya, Burma, Thailand, Vietnam, and Sri Lanka and Babylon too. Rocks have been cut from the mountains and shaped into statue of Buddha. Even today we can see Gangetic statue of Buddha in Angkor Wat of Cambodia and Bamiyan of Afghanistan. Unfortunately, the huge statue of Buddha in Bamiyan came under attack and were destroyed in recent times. In 1965, inspired by Buddha's teaching, India prominent social philosopher and architecture of constitution Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar embraced Buddhism also. After Buddha's death, his followers collected his teachings and tradition in the form of Tripitakas. These are Vinaya, Dhamma and Abhidhamma Pitakas. Over a period of time, and that is we can say as the disagreements developed in the teachings of different branches of Buddhism and sprung up. Thus, Hinayana, Mahayana, Vajrayana and other sutras came into being. Today, we see many organizations across the globe adopting different ways of realizing Buddha. So, after that foreign invasion, during this period sprang of cities, city-state in Greece, ancient Persia had grown into two areas engaged in the continental conflicts, the Achaemenians were a group of who ruled Persia in 6th century BCE. King Darius of the Dis dynasty established a strong empire. His kingdom extended up to the Indian border during this time. In 4th century BCE, the Macedonian king Alexander won over Greek city-states and captured Persia. Thus, even the part of Persian kingdom which had spread up to the Indian border came under the control of Alexander. After overpowering Persia, Alexander entered India through the passes of Kandahar and Hindu Kush. He advanced till Ravi and Bees rivers, and unable to proceed further, he crossed the Indian border through the river Jhelum, and on his way back to home, he died at Babylonia. The battle between Alexander and Pururava. When Alexander accepted the invitation of Ambi, the king of Takshashila, and came to India, it was Pururava that he had to conflict. Pururava was also called Porus. The two armies faced each other on the banks of the river Jhelum, which was flooded and wild at that time. Alexander's army attacked Pururava, who had never expected anyone to cross the swollen river, and won. Alexander asked captured Pururava how desired to be treated. Pururava replied with pride and courage, "As one king deserved to be treated by another, Pururava's brave adventures have been immortalized in Greek writings." Alexander's attack led to the consolidation of small and big republics and establishment of the Mauryan dynasty. The arrival of Greeks influenced the North India art, science, proof and his influence can be found in the famous art form known as Gandhara art, which existed at that time. This is about the Jainism. Thank you for watching video. Have a great day ahead.